Hello. Are you a trauma nurse or doctor? Maybe a medical student rotating through your orthopedic surgery and trauma block, and you just can't seem to get the technique for that closed traction reduction of the cervical spine dislocation. Well, worry not. We've got just what you need. The 411 on cervical dislocations, as well as closed reduction using Cone's calipers. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this presentation of the potentially life-saving technique. Courtesy of fifth-year UCT medical students, Dr. Softman, and the staff of C27, C14, and D15 wards. Cone's calipers is a traction device used for the reduction and alignment of cervical spine C-spine dislocations. Closed traction reduction is typically indicated for C-spine dislocations such as flexion distraction and flexion rotation injuries. These are commonly a result of motor vehicle injuries, falls, or sports injuries. There is therefore often young people in their 30s that present with such injuries. On imaging, either unilateral or bilateral facet jump can be visualized. Spinal cord injury is a consequence of these dislocations and therefore invariably results in paraplegia in 50 to 84% of patients. The diagnosis of a C-spine dislocation, as with any orthopedic examination, entails a detailed history and a look, feel, and remove approach. In addition to this, radiographic assessment is essential to diagnosing a C-spine dislocation, as clinical examination alone will not suffice. History of the trauma may help reconstruct the forces applied to the spine at the time of injury, but it cannot tell you if the injury is either stable or unstable. Careful scrutiny of the pain, as well as associated distal features, will assist in pointing to the diagnosis of a C-spine dislocation or fracture. An X-ray of the spine in the lateral, AP, and open mouth views is required to confirm the diagnosis. CT and MRI usually aren't readily available in the emergency setting, but can be used for a more detailed assessment of the spinal canal, as well as the discs and ligaments when required. We will now very briefly revise the interpretation of a normal C-spine X-ray. In the open mouth view, it is important that you can visualize the lateral masses of C1 and C2 odontoid peg. The distance between the lateral masses and the peg will be compared on both sides, and they should be equal unless there's a dislocation or fracture, or the patient is rotated. In the lateral and AP views, it should cover the area from C1 to T1. In a normal C-spine, the intervertebral spaces should be equal and consistent throughout. The vertebral anterior vertebral body, posterior vertebral body, and spinolaminar lines should all have smooth lines with no steps. For a detailed revision, see the video on curing the C-spine on X-ray, diagnosing C-spine fractures. The video is linked on the references at the end of this video. The initial management is, of course, to follow ATLS guidelines with careful management of airways and C-spine immobilization, breathing, circulation, disability, as well as consideration of external or environmental factors. Then it is safe to commence with spinal realignment and decompression of the cord to optimize neurological outcome. Dislocations can be definitively managed by either open or closed reduction. We'll be demonstrating the latter using Cone's calipers, so stick around. Why use Cone's calipers? Closed reduction has an 80% success rate with less than 1% worsening of neurological status, and it takes approximately 30 minutes to apply, deeming it highly effective, safe, and relatively time efficient. Animal studies, as well as a Cape Town study of 57 rugby players with cervical spine facet dislocations, showed that time from injury to intervention significantly affected the neurological outcome, with a 64% reduction in neurological deficit if treated within 4 hours. Partly based on these findings, in 2015, a South African constitutional court ruled that closed reduction should be applied to all cervical dislocations within 4 hours. This means that it will often be performed by the emergency doctor at the primary hospital where the patient presents. Furthermore, it is a World Health Organization requirement that the equipment to apply Cone's calipers is available in every district-level hospital and above. It is also useful to note that Cone's calipers can also be used in the management of other spinal pathology, particularly maintaining traction in odontoid pathology, such as fractures. Before we commence, here's a short checklist to ensure that both you and the patient are ready for the application of the cones. The prerequisites for applying Cone's calipers is that the patient is awake, alert, and cooperative. Ongoing neurological and physiological monitoring must be done. And of course, this procedure must be done by a trained clinician, which after the watching of this video will hopefully be you. Absolute contraindications are an unconscious or uncooperative patient, as well as basal skull fractures. Relative contraindication is a severe degloving or septic wound on the skull.
The equipment required for a close traction reduction is a reduction bed and double mattress, weights and a weight holder, a swan neck and S-hook, an orthopedic rope. For a close traction reduction, you will need the patient to complete consent forms, as with any medical procedure, an IV set, analgesia and sedation. We use midazolam, morphine, and stematol with the doses as indicated. You'll need cardiac and oxygen saturation monitoring, a razor and a blade, local anesthetic, Cone's calipers, a suturing kit, and of course, gloves for your safety. We will now demonstrate close traction reduction using Cone's calipers. As with any medical procedure, we will need to acquire consent. ATLS guidelines will have been followed, and so the patient will have had an IV line connected in already. Now to begin with the Cone's calipers application. Identify the area 1 centimeter above the pinna and in line with the external auditory meatus, and shave. You'll ideally use a razor for this, but we have a blade in this video. Palpate to exclude any blood vessels in the area, especially the temporal artery. Apply 5 cc of local anesthetic to the area, raising a blade of the skin. Apply it right down to the periosteum and give it about 2 minutes to settle. Make a small incision of about 0.5 centimeter in the area, and then commence with blunt dissection till you get to the periosteum. Put the pins into the holes and adjust until lying on the bone. Adjust the pins until secure into the bone. Give it a gentle tug to ensure that it is secure. An AP x-ray can be done to ensure that the pins are in the correct position and correct depth. The calipers can now be attached to the S-hook. This is attached to the swan neck pulley system. The weights of 5 kgs are attached at first and added as required. Your assistant can now help remove the collar.
With the collar now off and weights applied, place the neck in the extended position and remove the pillow or support from beneath. Assessment of the success of the reduction entails monitoring the patient's vitals and radiological and neurological investigations and examination respectively. If there's no reduction after 10 minutes, add 2 to 5 kilograms and reassess after 10 minutes. Repeat as required until you reach a maximum weight of 40 kilograms as per Huttiskier Hospital guidelines. A full neurological assessment and vitals check must be done at 10-minute intervals. Close traction reduction using Cone's calipers is not without its complications. In 80% of people, successful reduction will be achieved. Be aware of the possibility of over-distraction and exclude this on radiographic imaging as you monitor and assess the patient. A failure to reduce the dislocation is possible and can be declared once a maximum of 40 kg weight has been applied, or if there is hemodynamic or neurological deterioration, which is seen in less than 1% of cases. We'd like to acknowledge the following people and thank you for watching this video. We hope it was helpful. This video is purely for educational purposes. Comments are welcome.